Was Spent by Filter off of their 1995 debut album Short Bus. Filter is actually a band started by, well, one of the founders anyway was Richard Patrick, their lead singer, who was actually the touring guitarist for Nine Inch Nails right before he started this album. Basically, Trent went off to go record the Downward Spiral, and this was just something for Patrick to fill the time until he, released it and got really big. This was a pretty big album for him. Everything after this, I don't love from Filter. Title of Record is all right, but definitely they key way back on the anger, which after that I kind of stopped listening to them because I still wanted heavy music and they didn't make heavy music anymore. I was more forgiving when Nine Inch Nails stopped making heavy music. I don't know what's up with that. It's just being a kid, I guess. We're listening to that today because we have a White Zombie song, Up in Competition, that's from 1995. Hi, my name is Bean, and you're watching Battle of the Band. We're on day 16 of the White Zombie Tournament. That is match 9 in round 2. And if you're new here, you're not sure what a White Zombie Tournament is, I'll fill you in a little bit. What we did was we took every single song White Zombie ever released, threw them into a single elimination-style tournament, and now they're battling head-to-head until there's one left remaining in the end, and that'll be the very best song that White Zombie have ever released. We're in the second round of the tournament, and we had a whole round of buys, basically. First, we had 8 different matches that decided which songs would get thrown into the 64-bracket tournament, basically. So it'll be the first time we'll be listening to both the songs we're doing today. Our 2 songs today are from the last White Zombie album, as well as the debut album, so this will be a fun one, comparing very early to very late White Zombie, split up by almost 8 years. First up today, we'll be listening to Grease Paint and Monkey Brains, which was released on their 1995 album Astrocreep 2000, Songs of Love, Destruction, and Other Synthetic Delusions of the Electric Head. And this song is pretty cool. I remember this one from back in the day. Pretty cool song. I don't know Drowning the Colossus as well. I did listen to it once when I was going through the buy rounds, but I don't recall it. It was only the one time I'd listened to it. But that's off of their 1987 debut album, Soul Crusher. So let's go ahead and get into these songs and see which one's the better of the two. First up, we'll be starting with Grease Paint and Monkey Brains. We'll be right back. interesting outro. You can tell that was meant to go straight into the next song, which would have been I, Zombie. We haven't heard that one yet on the channel. That'll be coming up. I really like that sound. I don't know what the sound was. It's something being reversed, and they kind of used it in the rhythm portion of the song. Just like slightly in there. That's my favorite part of the song. I really like the way the vocals are for the most part too. I was kind of like a more of a whisper growl. Pretty cool. I like it. And of course, you know, the Dawn of the Dead quote. Can't go wrong with that. All right. Let's go ahead and see how Drowning the Colossus stands up. Here we go.
Yeah.
song is wild. I really enjoyed that. The vocals are really neat. Like, something you don't really understand what he's saying unless you're, like, if you're reading along with it, it's a little easier. But even then, it's still hard. Like, it says the eyes humming in the lyrics on genius.com, but he's all like, it's really unique. I like it. I really enjoy that song. It doesn't have the groove that Grease Paint and Monkey Brains has, which it that song fucking does groove. Man, it's got that high-pitched backward sample I love. Dawn of the Dead quote. I think I'm gonna give that one to Grease Paint and Monkey Brains, although Drowning the Colossus is a very solid and worthy competitor. Drowning the Colossus is super good news for me. Very just kind of like cool vocal style. I really like, again, how things sound like they're coming, but like during the transitions, things sound like they're falling apart a little bit. And I kind of like that aspect of it. But Grease Paint and Monkey Brains, I think, is a stronger song overall. At least as far as like something that's going to stay in your head a bit more and you can groove a little easier to it. It's not as difficult to process for your brain. Not that being difficult to process is a bad thing. Art should be, you know, complex when you need it to be. Not that Drowning the Colossus is complex really either, though. It's a really good song, but it's not going through the next round. We've got social media if you want to talk about it. You can feel free to yell at me, argue with me, or agree with me on TikTok, Instagram, or Facebook. I also have a TikTok account. On Twitter, Instagram, or Facebook. I also have a TikTok account. If you feel like the videos are a little too long and you'd like to see them shortened down, well, there's a good way to do it right there. It's called TikTok, you silly goose. I will link all the songs as well as the tournament bracket down in the description. Although if you look right below me here, you'll see the URL for the tournament bracket pop up. And you can type that in and check it out if you'd like to. Got a Venmo and a Cash App. If you feel like donating to the channel in any way, that's the way you would go about doing that. I am doing a promotion right now where I will hand out these No Ringo, No Life buttons for anyone who donates $10 or more. If you donate more than $10, maybe more than one button, depending on how much you donate, you know, $20, two buttons. It's not really about buying the buttons, though. It's more about supporting the channel and, you know, we appreciate that. Like this video if you like the video and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. I'm seeing those subscribes going up and up and up, and I really appreciate that. I'm sure my like ratio is going down, but I haven't really paid much attention to that. You know, strangers aren't into it. They're like, why was I directed here? Dislike. Glad they don't show the thumbs downs anymore. My ego would be crushed. Share the video with your friends and family members, anyone you know that might be into White Zombie content like this, or music content in general, or anyone that just needs a No Ringo, No Life button in their lives. I've got several. I'll give you a bunch. Donate a bunch of money. Comment down below with which of these two songs you would have chosen if you were in the hot seat today. And that is all the music tournament action I've got going for the day. Thank you for joining. I hope you had fun hanging out, and I hope you come by next time. Tomorrow. That's the next time. Hope you have a great night, a fantastic afternoon, and a wonderful morning.